Dear Mr. President, dear Mr. Toastmaster, dear fellows and guests, this year is absolutely unusual for celebrating anniversaries of the great people. And this people is known all over the world. And one of them is Charles Darwin. Charles Darwin was born in 1812 in Portland, Hampshire, is the southern of England. He was famous for his great works, and this very day is the public of almost in the most countries of the world is celebrating their anniversaries. So let's join them. The Dickens' works were very complicated, and now it's necessary to divide it into some parts. He was the first novelist who was concerned with the critical realism. And he was the new person. He was one of the new person who devoted this style of reading. And he showed the spirit of the English life better than everybody. No one knew the English 19th century better than he. He described everyday life and everyday people. He considered every person as a hero. He described factories, the offices of a big firm, factories, prisons, and slums of London. He had a style of his own. The secret of his style was in a, in a combination of realism of detail and fantasy. He drew a definite, a strict line between that all and that is bad. And so let's remember his Christmas stories, where we can see good home and good people. And Mr. Dombey and Dickens compared him to the Pope. So, I saw some novel. Dickens created a new type of novel, a social novel, involving social feelings, social thinking, and emotions. He considered abnormal the great contrast between rich and poor. He had his own attitude to the poverty and exploitation. So he tried to present all the human nature in a good qualities. Those time England was the richest country in the world, and Dickens understood that the wealth of this country are in the hand of a small group of capitalists, and the mass lived in at the mercy of the rich. He wished to solve this unsolvable problem, and he tried to do it friendly and gently. And so he, and for most of his novels, he invented happy endings. Characters. Dickens's characters are at first time was caricatures and satirical, but because of exaggeration, but this exaggeration was in some time really and really exists. Part of Dickens's works devoted to children. The fate of the children presented a much alarm for Dickens. And no one knew better the poor children's life better than he. He considered that they spend most of the time in the slums and tried to help him. But due to this, he tried to present them child heroes and heroines that they remain pure till the end. Dickens had a special feelings to his youngest brother, and he used a nickname given by him. His nickname was Boz, and sometimes he even signed his novels by using this nickname. So if you see if you read some novels and see the side Nick, it means it was given by his little brother. They traveled, Dickens and his family traveled a lot. He visited many countries and traveled not only via England. He visited France, Italy, Switzerland, and even USA. And everywhere he met a very hearty welcome. Dickens was an example for many writers all over the world. And I permit myself to read a quotation given by Leo Tolstoy, our great writer. He said, "All the characters are my personal friends. I am constantly comparing them with living persons, and living persons with them. And what a spirit there was in all," he wrote.